The situation is well in hand. Redeeming the Time Brothers podcast, a podcast by Gene Kissinger and Norman Kissinger, two brothers who spent their lives in ministry and raising large families. Our desire is to provide a digital place for those who long to belong. We are developing discipleship tools, distributing them across multiple platforms to bring about a rapture-ready body of believers so that when Jesus Christ comes back, he'll have no trouble recognizing his own children. Tonight's nightlight is out of Isaiah chapter 49 and verse 16. Behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hands. Thy walls are continually before me. I've always been fascinated by this verse, and today I was drawn to it in my devotional time, and I read some from Spurgeon and then another comment that I wanted to read to you. Spurgeon adds to the phrase, I have graven thee does not say thy name, our name is here, but that is not all. I have graven thee, see the fullness of this. I have graven thy person, thy image, thy cause, thy circumstances, thy sins, thy temptations, thy weaknesses, thy wants, thy works. I have graven thee, everything about thee, all that concerns thee. I have put thee all together there. Wilt thou ever say again that thy God hath forsaken thee when he hath graven thee on the palm of his own hands? And then another commentator wrote this, Vance Havner said, Scripture records, neither shall any man snatch them out of my hand or out of my Father's hand, John 10. Behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hands, Isaiah 49, 16. My times are in thy hand, Psalms 31, 15. Vance Havner refers to those passages as having the situation well in hand. Indeed, it is well in hand. You and I can move into our day and even seasons of distress and stress and know that God's got it in hand. God has never fumbled the ball. This is football season, and you'll see quarterbacks throwing the ball to receivers. Inevitably, the receiver is not quite at the right angle, and he'll bobble the ball and then ultimately drop the ball. Or the quarterback will fumble the ball while he's trying to pass it, and the crowd boos because it was fumbled. Well, God never fumbles. God never drops the ball. God never makes a mistake. And sometimes we make our way through this sin-cursed world, and we are touched by the infirmities that are around us, and we're hurt in the spiritual warfare that's going on. The temptation is to somehow think that God has forsaken us. God's obviously forgotten you, or you wouldn't be going through this hard time. Well, the reality is God warned us that hard times were coming. He said, in the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. And that one that's overcome the world has us in the palm of his hand. And that his Father in heaven has us engraved in the palm of his hand. Everything about us, our whole story from beginning to end. He declares the end from the beginning. He knows exactly what's going on. He knows exactly what he's doing, and we can trust him. I need to remind myself of that sometimes, because sometimes our human relationships fail. Our human situations fall apart, and we need to understand there's a God that's got it all together, and he's got us in the palm of his hand. Let's pray. Dear Lord God, I thank you for this day. I pray that you'd bless those under the sound of my voice. I know that some of them feel like their life is falling apart right now, God. There are some that are just so devastated by news they've heard, maybe even this week, God, that is just, it's wrecked them, God. They are just devastated by it. And I'm asking you to innervate them with the power and presence of your Spirit, to raise them up to a place of wellness and wholeness as they trust in your providential care over them. Remind them that their times are in your hand, that they're engraved in the palm of your hand, that they're held in your hand. I pray that you just watch out over us as we rest tonight. Allow us to rest with that security that we have based on our relationship with you. Help us to ever believe. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, God bless you. I love you, but Jesus loves you so much more. Have a great night. Shalom.